Since we've already covered Convergent Pokemon twice, I thought it would be fun to take a shot at Paradox forms. I really like the Paradox concept, but instead of using Final Evolution Pokemon, I will be using the first stage starters. Our first target is Chikorita. Paradox designs are very similar to the original pieces, so I used a tracing method in order to keep the main aesthetic the same. I decided to base this form off of a prehistoric plant, which I may have made up myself because I just can't find it online, but I do think we put in some elements that actually makes him look like a Paradox form. Take the teeth, the little petals, and maybe a little bit more of a mean look, for example. I'm especially in love with the way I rendered the eyes. For the colors, I didn't change up much. The only big difference are the flowers on its body that went from green to pink.
Ravaging Blossom. They're Paradox Pokemon. This mysterious Pokemon is said to be a merge between an ancient form of plant life and a dinosaur. It may look like a Chikorita, but be warned, this Pokemon is way more powerful.
I think I've done a pretty good job on this one. It's pretty similar to the original design, but it is still different enough to sell as a Paradox Pokemon. The teeth and the little petals actually make him look way more feral, which is sort of what a past form of Paradox Pokemon is. More teeth, longer hair, or any spikes. Up next is a future form for Rowlet. At first I didn't really like the future Paradox forms, but since I made this drawing, I've actually fallen in love with the idea. The future designs are mainly just the base design, but then with a black screen-like thing on their head, where the eyes look more like lights than actual eyes. They also replace certain features with a lava lamp kind of feel. At first I wasn't really a fan of the shinies for these guys, because they are just colorless. But since I put them on my own drawings, I actually get why they did that. From the moment you put in the shiny colors, it immediately sells as a robot, which is fantastic.
Iron Hood, the Paradox Pokemon. This Pokemon is said to be a weird organism with a relatively simple mechanism. The coding does appear to be incredibly advanced though. Nobody knows who created this creature, but it does still appear to love cuddles.
The name Iron Hood? Fantastic. Thank you so much, Benjamin. I definitely think this could be sold as a futuristic form of Rowlet. The fact that its wings aren't attached to its body anymore, and that he has those light-like eyes, instantly sells him as a robot to me. If you're not convinced that he is a robot, just look at his shiny. The third Pokemon as a past form was Squirtle. I may have made a small mistake on this one. Instead of turning this Pokemon into a Paradox form, I sort of turned him into a Convergent Pokemon. I do think this is one of the best designs I've made so far. But yeah, it's not the best Paradox Pokemon. I did still want to show him in this video because I just love him so much. And I really think you like him too. I turned Squirtle into an Ankylosaur? Something like that. Coming back to the point I said earlier, I know you do actually have to use the same colors as the regular Squirtle. So that's why he's totally different than sort of a Convergent Pokemon. Because we used the brown colors, which look way better. But we did turn the shiny into a shiny Squirtle, so I tried.
Smashing Shell, the not-so-good Paradox Pokemon. This Pokemon is supposedly born from boulders when they hit Earth from the highest of mountains. Even though this Pokemon resembles Squirtle quite a lot, this Pokemon is actually way stronger.
Like I said before, this isn't the best Paradox Pokemon, but you have to agree that it looks pretty sick. I especially like the way I rendered it with the scales. That really sells him as a dinosaur. We're closing in on a 1600 subscribers. That's incredible. Please make sure to subscribe. Our fourth candidate is a future form of Chimchar. This was another pretty easy design to convert into a future form, but it did take me some time to figure out how to make his eyes work. I eventually settled on dark screen-like circles on his face, and I think that worked out great. At some point I was testing if I could put the lava lamp kind of feel on his head as well, but I'm glad I didn't do that. For the colors, we just changed the pale yellow for a dark gray color. I would have loved to give the shiny blue flames, because that's just the way you should make flames into a shiny color. But yeah, that's just not how Paradox Pokemon work, so we will just have the red on his shiny as well.
Iron Monkey, the Paradox Pokemon. This Pokemon may look cute and friendly, but rumors have it that it's actually very mean. Only the toughest trainers can handle this Pokemon, and even they have struggles with the obedience of this little demon. It loves to bully other Pokemon, and it can do that very well with the huge amount of firepower it has.
At one point I wasn't really sure if this drawing would come together, but I do think the end result is amazing. This really looks like a robotic Chimchar, and I'm really happy someone suggested to detach his head from its body. This made the design way more unique, and I love it. Our last Pokemon is a future form of Mudkip. I decided to just tweak the original art and not even make a sketch. This sped up the process by a long time, and this might actually be my favorite design of all of them. But I'm probably biased, because Mudkip is amazing. For the colors, I really didn't change much for this guy. The only thing I did was add a screen for his face where you have the light eyes again, and the other colors just basically stayed the same.
Iron Fin. The Paradox Pokemon. It is thought by some to be an underwater camera drone made by an alien race. We have not yet to confirm this rumor, but it does appear to come very close to you, and it loves to be petted. Might this be a strategy to spy on you, or is it just a friendly Pokemon?
I have to say that if this Pokemon was real, I would instantly go for a shiny. And yeah, this Pokemon might actually be a good contender for one of my favorite Pokemon. I love him. I am very happy with all of these designs, and I definitely want to do this challenge again. Next week we'll transform 5 other starters into a Paradox Pokemon. And I'll try to not make another Convergent Pokemon. Goodbye.